is Magic on top, a 3-0 lead on Hardy. Meanwhile, McNeil and Woods in the third period, tied at one. This match to be settled on the feet. Riding time, not a factor.
Here comes the scrambling. Head up. Might he look for a cradle himself? He's got it. Oh, go! Nice job of the breaking it right away. There's no rolling through on a cradle locked up like that.
And then gets to a Merkle. Still in control, Red. Looks like a spladle. We got a spladle.
Yeah, but. Yep, he's got the count going.
A spladle in the quarterfinals. Man.
And there is nowhere Hardy can go from this position, and the clock just continues to tick.
And you're just right. You cannot stalemate this. When someone's in near fall criteria, there's no stalemating this at all.
Mendez pulled everything out of his tool chest. He's just gotten so much better, and he had to use it all against a competitor like Hardy.
But this gives you bonus points here. You'll get the 4 near fall, and the riding time makes it 10-2, which helps Ohio State.
You can just see the helplessness on the face of Brock Hardy. There was absolutely nothing he could do once the spladle was locked in.
Speaking of cradles, Lackland McNeil has got a sit, but look at the toughness there. The dog in him. Did he get it? And he's got the takedown. Lackland McNeil.
Let's go down to Quint. He's with Jesse Mendez.
Jesse, congratulations. You ended up that match with a spladle. It's not an everyday occurrence in the NCAA quarterfinals. What the heck happened?
You know, I haven't had a spladle since I was like first year wrestler. So
seriously,
you know, bring on the quarterfinals, you got to find a way to win. That's what I did.
I saw you break a cradle that he had just for a moment against you. And like you understood the urgency. What was going through your mind?
Score points. You know, he's tough. He's real tough. He's tough on top. And, you know, you slip up for a second, you're giving up back points. So he's got to keep wrestling.
Congratulations. Terrific ending.
Wild finishes